I was a boy who lived long ago in the frozen north. He was determined to prove himself a man, but never dreamt that his path to becoming one would mean being changed into his own worst enemy and learning to see the world as Brother Bear. Let's begin now. In a land of snow and ice, an old storyteller stood before a cave painting.
This is a story from long ago. When mammoths still roamed our lands in great herds. It's the story of my two brothers and I. When the three of us were young, we were taught that the world is full of magic. Small things become big. Winter turns to spring. One thing always changes into another. But the greatest change I ever saw was that of my brother, a boy who desperately wanted to be a man.
The old storyteller, whose name was Danahi, described the day when it all began. He was returning from a fishing trip with his younger brother, Kenai, and older brother, Sitka. Kenai was about to have his manhood ceremony and receive a spirit rock, or totem, showing his special gift. Kenai tried to imagine his.
Yeah, I'll probably get like a saber-toothed tiger for bravery, or strength, or greatness.
Kenai tied his basket of fish to a tree, but the knot came loose, and the basket fell. Ignoring it, Kenai ran to catch up with his brothers. They entered a cave where the people were gathered around Tanana, a woman of mystery and magic. She beckoned to Kenai, and he stepped forward.
Kenai, I have been to the mountain where the lights touch the earth, and the great spirits have made a totem representing your gift. To become a man, you must understand one thing. Your totem is...
his neck, she hung a small rod carved in the shape of a bear. She motioned to a cave wall covered with handprints.
Love is a very powerful gift. It helps us see beyond our differences. Love can change everything. When you truly understand this, you will place your mark next to those of our ancestors.
Afterward, Danahi put flowers on Kenai's head and made fun of his totem. Danahi ran away laughing as Sitka watched.
Just because his totem is wisdom doesn't mean he's wise.
Kenai hung his head.
Yeah, I guess the spirits messed up on both of our totems.
You know, I felt the same way when Tanana gave me mine. I said, the eagle of guidance? What does that mean? But now that I'm older, I know it's about being a leader and keeping an eye on you two.
Why is it a bear? I mean, a bear doesn't love anyone. I mean, they're thieves.
Kenai and Sitka found Danahi under a tree, staring at the remains of the fish basket. Next to it were the paw prints of a bear. Danahi and Sitka glared.
You didn't tie it up, did you? Typical Kenai.
Relax. I'll go get the basket. I'm sure the bear dropped it somewhere.
Kenai fled into the forest, where he found the rest of the basket. And an angry bear. He cried out, and his brothers ran to help. They lowered the bear onto a glacier where it attacked. As the bear closed in on Danahi and Kenai, Sitka stopped it the only way he could, by plunging his spear into an icy crevice. The glacier slid away, dumping the bear and Sitka into the freezing water hundreds of feet below. The bear climbed out and lumbered off. Sitka didn't. He was gone. That night, the grieving villagers built a funeral pyre. Kenai and Danahi put Sitka's belongings in a fire and watched them. Kenai turned to Danahi.
Our brother is dead, and it's because of that monster.
I don't blame the bear, Kenai. Killing that bear won't make you a man. Thanks for your wisdom.
Kenai hurled his totem into the fire. fire and stalked off to find the bear. Tanana, who was watching, scooped the totem from the flames. Danahi took it and followed his brother.
I've got to stop him.
Tanana gazed up at the northern lights flickering across the sky.
You left too soon, Seeker. Your brothers need your guidance.
Kenai found the bear in a berry patch, sniffing around the bushes. Gripping his spear, Kenai chased the bear to the edge of a cliff, where suddenly it turned on, knocking away the spear. Kenai cried out in fear. Danahi, meanwhile, reached the berry patch and saw Kenai's footprints next to those of the bear. As he followed them, he heard his brother's cry. He looked up in alarm.
Kenai!
At the cliff, the bear closed in for the kill. Kenai lunged for his spear. Raising it, he shut his eyes and braced himself. When he opened his eyes, he was amazed to find the bear lying on top of him, dead. Stabbed by the spear. Just then, the skies opened up, and a column of light descended. Animal spirits spilled out of the column. Wolves, salmon, bears, an eagle met by Kenai and changed the view. Kenai was lifted into the sky. He whirled around as lights flashed and glowed. Gradually, he was transformed into a grizzly bear. Disappeared as mysteriously as it had come. Danahi, who had been searching for Kenai in the rocks below, finally caught up. He saw a bear standing among Kenai's clothes and assumed it had killed his brother.
No!
Lightning ripped through the air. Kenai, losing his balance, toppled over the cliff and into the river below. He was carried by rapids over a waterfall. Danahi, watching from above, vowed that he would follow the bear and kill it in revenge. The next morning, Kenai opened his eyes and found himself on a riverbank. Beside him was Tanana.
So, Kenai, you decided to join the living.
Suddenly, Kenai remembered. He had become his most hated enemy, a bear.
No!
Kenai, Sitka did this. If you want to change, take it up with your brother's spirit. You'll find him on the mountain where the lights touch the earth.
As Tanana disappeared into the mist, Kenai heard voices. He looked around and was amazed to see two moose talking to him.
Yeah, hey, my name's Rut. This is my brother, Duke.
How's it going, Bear?
Don't call me that.
Oh, sorry, Mr. Bear?
No, I mean, I'm not a bear. I hate bears. Do either of you know where the lights touch the earth?
Duke glanced at his brother.
Oh, yeah. See, we're not moose either.
Kenai turned away in disgust.
I'll find it myself.
When he started to leave, he was flying into the air. He had stepped into a trap. Rut and Took wandered off, leaving Kenai dangling upside down from a rope. A small bear approached.
Just can't see the trap. Let me help.
He found a stick and began swinging it at Kenai.
Ow! Dump it! I don't need some stupid bear's help. I just need the stick.
Kenai took the stick and tried to free himself, but it was no use. Just when it seemed hopeless, the bear knocked a wooden peg from the ground. Kenai went flying out of the trap into the air. When he landed, he looked up and saw his brother.
Danahi, you found me!
Danahi?
It's me, Kenai!
But all Danahi heard was the growl of the bear that had taken his brother. Danahi picked up his spear and attacked. Kenai fled to a cave, where he hid with a small bear until Denahi left. The bear, whose name was Koda, had been separated from his mother and was going to look for her at a beautiful river filled with salmon.
There's a lot of bears and a ton of fish, and every night we watch the lights touch the mountain. And last year,
what did you just say? You know where the lights touch the earth?
Yes, the top of the mountain, right by the salmon run.
Kenai, recalling what Tanana had told him, had no choice but to go with the cub. The two bears set out the next day. Kenai was in a hurry, but Koda wanted to play. The little bear blew dandelion puffs, told stories, and wouldn't stop singing. Everything he did got on Kenai's nerves. Finally, he convinced Kenai to balance with him on a ledge, and they went tumbling into a puddle. Covered with mud, Kenai couldn't help but laugh. Farther along the trail, someone called out.
Hey! Hold on!
It was Rut and Took. The four of them hitched a ride on mammoths and headed for the mountain. That night as they rode, Koda pointed to the northern lights.
Rainbow. You can see the spirits from here.
Kenai looked up sadly.
My brother's a spirit. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be here. He was killed by a monster.
What's your mother's name?
Sitka.
Koda gazed up at the lights.
Thanks, Sitka. If it weren't for you, I would have never met Kenai. I always wanted a brother.
The next morning, Kenai and Koda woke up to find that they were lost. They hopped off the mammoths, leaving Rut and Took behind. When Kenai blamed Koda, the little bear bristled.
Just remember, if it weren't for me, you'd still be hanging upside down right now.
Yeah, well, better than being stuck in the middle of nowhere with you and your blabbering mouth.
Kenai, seeing that he had hurt Koda's feelings, followed the little bear into a cave, where a painting showed a hunter using a spear to fight a grizzly. Koda looked at the painting nervously.
Those monsters are really scary. Especially with those sticks.
Kenai was shocked to realize that in Koda's eyes, the people were the monsters. They set out through a forest. At the top of a hill, Koda perked up.
Wait a second. The salmon run's not far. We just have to go through here.
As they made their way past jagged cliffs and molten lava, a spear landed nearby. Kenai turned and saw Denahi, bruised and wild-eyed, charging toward them. Koda ran.
Come on!
The two bears came to a deep gorge with a log bridge. As they crossed it, the bridge collapsed. They dangled over the gorge with a raging river far below. Finally, they dove to safety on the other side. Kenai watched as Denahi, desperate to reach them, tried to leap across. He hung on for a moment, then plunged into the gorge. Landing in the water, he looked up at the bears as he was swept away by the current. As the bears set out again, Koda was puzzled.
Why do they hate us, Kenai?
Bears. Most bears will look for any excuse to attack a human.
Which bears? I'm not like that, and you're not like that.
You're just a cub. When you're older, you'll understand.
Just then, a flock of seagulls swooped down towards them. Ahead of them was a clearing with a wide river. Koda laughed.
We made it! We're here! Come on!
Kenai ran after Koda, but fell headlong into a river stream. Looking up, he was shocked to find himself surrounded by a dozen huge bears. One of the bears winced.
Yeah, try not to scare off the fish there, buddy.
Koda recognized the bear as Tug, an old friend.
Have you seen my mom yet?
Oh, as a matter of fact, I haven't seen her.
Tug gazed at Kenai.
I've never seen you at the run before. Where are you from?
As Kenai struggled to answer, Koda pointed excitedly.
And see, Kenai, there's the mountain, just like I promised. The lights touch the top every single night.
Kenai pulled Koda aside.
Dakota, I gotta get going.
Well, when you come back, we can go and...
I won't be coming back.
What? Why not?
Well, it's just that I don't belong here.
Tug, who was listening, couldn't believe his ears.
Don't belong? Every bear belongs here. Come on, buddy.
He and Coda showed Kino around. Bears were fishing, laughing, telling stories. Watching them, Kenai started to feel at home, like part of a family. That night, the bears took turns telling stories. When it was Kenai's turn, he looked at Coda.
I went on the longest, hardest, most exhausting journey I've ever been on, with the biggest pain in the neck I've ever met. What do you expect from a little brother?
Coda looked up at Kenai and beamed. Then it was Coda's turn. He told how his mother had been attacked by a human and had fallen off a glacier.
She fell in the water, okay, but that's how we got separated. Right after that, I met Kenai.
Kenai wasn't there. He was stumbling through the woods, knowing Coda's story happened that day he had killed the bear. Now he knew that bear had been Coda's mother trying to protect her cub. When Coda found him, Kenai told him the truth.
Coda, I did something very wrong. Your mother's not coming.
Oh, no.
Coda, frightened and confused, fled to the trees.
I'm sorry, Coda. I'm so sorry.
But Kenai knew his words were no use. Having nothing left, he trudged off to the mountain. Late that night, in a blinding snowstorm, Kenai reached the top of the mountain and called out.
Sitka! Sitka, are you there?
A shadowy figure appeared, but it wasn't Sitka. It was Danahi. With hatred in his eyes, he yelled at Kenai. The brothers, human and bear, wrestled in a life-and-death struggle. They fell onto a ledge, where Kenai, stunned, looked up to see Danahi draw his knife and close in for the kill. Kenai no longer had the will to fight his brother. As Danahi was about to strike, a brown blur came out of nowhere and knocked him down. It was Coda. Danahi rose and turned on the little bear. Kenai cried out,
"No! Leave him alone!"
Kenai charged at Danahi's waiting spear. A flash of light illuminated the sky for miles around. There was a rustle of wings. A giant, glowing eagle swept in and lifted Kenai to safety. As it set him down, lights whirled around Kenai, and he changed back into a human. The Nahi stared.
Kenai?
Realizing he had almost killed his brother, the Nahi dropped his spear. The eagle landed between them. Suddenly, it transformed into Sitka. Kenai gazed at his brothers, then walked past them to a rock where Coda was crouched, trembling.
Coda. Coda, don't be afraid. It's me.
The little bear, recognizing something in his eyes, jumped into Kenai's arms. Kenai looked up at his brothers.
He needs me.
The Nahi, who was still carrying Kenai's totem, placed it around his brother's neck.
No matter what you choose, you'll always be my little brother.
Sitka smiled, the light swirled, and Kenai changed back into a bear. The Nahi shook his head in amazement.
Oh, did I say little?
The three brothers embraced. When they looked up, the spirit of Coda's mother had appeared and was holding Coda in her arms. Sitka joined her, and the two of them ascended into the light. Coda waved as his mother and Sitka the eagle disappeared into the lighted sky. Coda raced toward Kenai and tackled him playfully. Danahi leapt on, and they wrestled in the snow.
Oh,
Later, a ceremony took place. Tanana stood in a cave with Denahi as a crowd gathered around. The crowd parted, and Kenai the bear came forward. Denahi took his paw, dipped it into a bowl of paint, and pressed it to the wall beside the handprints of his ancestors. Kenai had achieved his wish. By choosing the path of love and staying a bear, he became a true man. Koda, held in the arms of a village child, squirmed free and ran to Kenai, his new brother. The villagers cheered. Kenai and Koda smiled. They looked up to see an eagle take off, flying toward the glowing lights of the nighttime sky.